question.
How much progress have you made on this so far?
I'm at about
195. That's about 195 more than I ever made.
Well, it's mostly pictures.
Okay, I can muscle through that. When you come up with a manga section of it, let me know.
Here you go. I didn't
finish my comic.
I swear
to God. That's so fucking cool. What
is something?
I remember the one thing that I like the show that we recorded for business. But it wasn't that
business. Oh, no,
we're not. There you go, we're home.
I thought you were kind of back from the theater. I was like, they're
home. You're doing volunteer work. No, the remotes that I did, first one, I was talking with them. And I was thinking, you know, building my first time, finally on main stage, you were already doing it.
Thank you. excuse me.
Thank you.
the top one on the right. There, that's it. Thanks for coming today. Just so folks know, kind of a rough plan, we have a little bit of structured stuff for about 45, 50 minutes, tops. And then the rest is just kind of unstructured social time to share good thoughts and memories of our friend Matt. Yeah, and then after we transition, that's when we'll put out all the food and stuff too. So we're gonna have some couple of speakers. We're gonna have some songs. We're gonna end the structure time with a group sing of Rainbow Connection, one of Matt's favorite songs. I think that's probably the stuff you need to know for this, right? Anything I'm forgetting? Organizers? Okay, so yeah, thanks for coming. Some of you traveled quite a distance, so really appreciate that. And if you don't know, there is a special Matt-inspired themed comedy sports match tonight where we will be playing games and doing things that we think Matt would have liked or appreciated. I will try to remember every ref bit that he ever did. Not only that. All right. So we've asked some folks to come up and say a few words or sing a song because they spent a lot of time with Matt and such. And we thought it would be good for them to lead us in sharing those memories and thoughts. So the first person is gonna be, I don't have my glasses on, so I can't really see, but I don't know where Gigi is. So Gigi, if you could come up.
Done this kind of already on some Zooms, you know. Hey, I otherwise don't have anything prepared. But as some of you know, he came and stayed with me and John and Jet over this last year when things fell out, and so we got to handhold him and cry with him and yell back at him for trying to feel guilty about things that he definitely had no control over. And of course, John and Jet knew him because they used to play Brunchens and Dragons, which was awesome. So, you know, for a couple of years, they every Sunday, they, you know, got to play with him and stuff. And I wasn't part of that because, God, D&D. Pretty much what it was. But of course, when he came to stay with us, I got to have a lot of great conversations with him, and I got to have I got to know him really well. And as I said, a lot of them were serious, which is funny because we also got inundated with the bits, which is great, you know, every couple Saturday nights, but oh my God, day in, day out. But yeah, he was always trying to make it funny, whatever it was. Also had a little too much his brain about all the trivia of anything we watched. And he seemed to even get used to the "Matt, shut up, just shut up." It didn't faze him a lot towards the end. But we got to see him, you know, really below, and then just over the year, get back up and really get a lot better, and just walking like crazy, and you know, teaching again, and really getting his life back. So it really pisses me off that he went ahead and just, granted, a lot of us were like, with all of his medical ailments or his, you know, thing going, oh, you're just stressed, stop stressing out, Matt. So we all, well, a lot of us contributed to the, it's not as bad as you think. But we also, in hindsight, of course, like, yeah, maybe you should have insisted more they get checked out of this or that. I'm not sure if it would have helped if anything was found earlier, but he just always didn't want to bother anybody with anything, so by the time he got to that hospital, it was like, as you guys know, it was like, wow, very far gone, and we thought we'd have longer. We hoped, of course, we'd have longer. And I'm just glad that, although she seems to be a bit late, that Charlotte was able to come, his mom, and be with him in those last weeks. And that I got to know her a little bit. And that I got to say goodbye, it seems, on one of the last nights he was still coherent. And even then, he was still essentially mumbling bits. it was great. And even though I wrangled at the term when he called me his second mom, I mean, I am not old enough. I feel very blessed to have been in his life and hopefully been a good friend. And I wish he just didn't have to go so soon. Damn it. So I love him. And I know you guys all do too. So that's what I have to say about Matthew.
Yeah, so as we know, Matt loved trivia. I do caution some of you, some of the trivia he shared with you was probably him making stuff up. I was telling Seth and Connie and Jeremy last night, he was obsessed with always trying to get me to believe implausible connections. He'd be like, Chris, you know, that Microsoft, Bill Gates, number two guy, Bill Allen. I'm like, yeah, and he goes, did you know he was like a track star in high school? And he was actually the inspiration for Barry Allen, The Flash. Just not true. He goes, you know, he'd keep trying, though. Like, usually at the end of a conversation, he'd have to throw something in there. Okay, so our next person, I actually don't know her that well. I do know a good friend of hers very well, and I've been lucky to get to know her better and as I moved up here to the area. But she was actually the friend of the person who's going to be up here. Is the first one of the first people from another city I ever met in comedy sports. The way I met her is at the Austin World Championship in 2000, and all of a sudden this person comes up to me and throws her arm around me and goes, "You are one of us now." And I'm like, "Ah!" And that grew into a big thing until the whole room was part of it. So, but she has a good friend named Shasha who's going to come here. And please welcome Shasha.
Matthew bought me from a semi-famous puppet maker named Kevin Gordy, but ever since then I've called him my dad. I've had a good time on Zoom playing the same game, but I think that the best part was the friends I made along the way. You know who you are. This is one of my favorite puppet hymns. When the mountain touches the valley, all the clouds are taught to fly. So our souls will leave this land most peacefully. Though our minds be full of questions, in our hearts we'll understand. When the river meets the sea, like a flower that has blossomed in the dry and barren sand, we are born and born again most gracefully. So the winds of time will take us with a sure and steady hand. When the river meets the sea, patience, my monster, and patience, my son. Like a baby when it is sleeping in its loving mother's arms, what a newborn baby dreams is mystery.
Mystery.
So we will find ourselves not remembering the words as the river meets the sea. If you know it, sing it. When the river meets the almighty sea. I'm gonna have to break the reality, guys.
What?
This is a shocker.
Oh, no.
All right. So, yeah, and speaking of trivia, I feel a little bad because I wrote out with Seth's help a Matt trivia contest, but in honor of Matt, I plan to print it out at the very last moment. And the timing got a little tight this morning. So if you want me to administer the Matt trivia question to me during the social time, I'd be more than happy to do so. Next speaker is a person who many people in Sacramento actually got to meet over the years because he would come down. In fact, he played with us during our first run at a temporary theater, and I always remember in particular in the game of halftime or countdown, he decided in the setup scene, this is at the Geary Theater, he was going to run up the right aisle, or walk up the right aisle, across the back, and then down knowing full well he was going to have to keep doing that like three or four times much faster, which if you've been to the Geary, it seems like a small place till you have to do it in 3 seconds. He was one of Matt's closest friends and sort of advisor, mentor as well. So Sam, could you come up and say a few words?
I had the pleasure of knowing Matt. I got to play with him in his very first show in Sacramento, and he loved to tell the story of how the last game was object freeze, and someone brought baby food, and I picked it up and took a big old scoop of it, and then I went back into the line, and I burped, and I blew it in his face, and I said, "Welcome to the family." I like to think about some of the good things. Matt loved. That was one emotion that he had no problems with. Matt loved people. He loved things. He loved improv. He loved theater. He loved bits. He had a bit that he wished would have been one of his own bits, and it wasn't really a bit, but it happened, and not a lot of people know. I think Pat knows the story. We went over to Boise. Kristen and I went over to Boise 4 years ago or so, and it was in January, February. We're driving back. I-84's getting shut down, and we're stuck. I think it was in La Grande, and we're trying to figure out, the three of us were kind of broke at the time. We're trying to figure out how we're getting money for a hotel room. We didn't plan on extra meals and all this, and then we find out that, okay, the road's going to be open. They're doing something, and we got to get going, but the windshield wipers on the van were just, I mean, we could hardly see out of them. So we go and we find new windshield wipers, and Matt's like, okay, I haven't been able to help very much at all, but I'm going to put on these windshield wipers, and I'm going to see us home. So he was on one of his missions. He gets the windshield wipers off, and he puts them on, and we're like, okay. So we get on to 84, and we're trying to go, and there's slush. There's trucks going by us and splashing all kinds of nasty stuff. And I'm driving, and these windshield wipers are 100 times worse, and I look at them, like, what is wrong with these? What is on the blade part? There's a piece he didn't take off. And it smeared it all over. And he was like, oh, I wish it could have been a bit. That would have been hilarious. I go, it still was, and it's still funny. It just wasn't on purpose. But what I remember most about Matt was he called me dad. And to be put in that kind of a position, it's a lot of responsibility. But I just, he'd ask me some hard questions. I'd just tell him how I felt. But he trusted me. And I'll always remember that he trusted me as much as I trusted him. And that's how we were really close. We just got to share a lot of good times together, hopes, tears, laughter. We got it all. You know, it wasn't long enough, but I got to be able to call him for so many years a very good friend. And we're lucky that he all affected us. We're lucky that he didn't hold back his love for any of us. If he loved you, you knew it because he told you. And he wanted all of us to smile. And that's what we have to carry on in life, is just knowing, hey, we don't always get the right amount of time, according to us, with everyone. But the time we get to look back. And we get to think about how special that was. And I'll never forget Matt. He is a wonderful, wonderful human. And I miss him. But we have all of us together. We can always remember him. And we can always talk about, remember that bit? Remember the windshield wipers? Remember how he almost killed us? It was great!
Yeah. I mean, so I'm going to say something that might seem a little morbid, and I'm sorry if it upset some of you, but it's something Matt would have appreciated. Honestly, all the times Matt hurt himself at at least in Sacramento. Lucky we got the time we did. Painting, and he's like, oh, shocked myself. He's like, oh, well, and he keeps going, like, no, stop! Don't do that anymore. Get off the ladder right now. Get off the metal ladder. I think what Sam said is true. So a lot of you know Evan Lucero from Sacramento. Evan and I have, Gigi, we played D&D together for a long time. Other games. And Matt had just joined a campaign that Evan had been in, and so I had to tell Evan what was going on. And he said, well, you know, Chris, I think it's kind of what they sometimes say is the brightest stars, unfortunately, burn the shortest. I think Pat is going to do a song that Matt specifically mentioned that he would like to be played or sung in such an event, unfortunately. And then after that, we're gonna watch the video that people recorded for Matt, and then we'll close up. So, all right, Pat.
My name is Balthazar Impresario. You'll find me at the bottom of the page. I have an artist's hands, though I'm a working man, but my craft has been forgotten by the age. So tonight will be my last night on the stage. This is my family's trade. My father built this place, the turning of the 20th century. I have been working here for over 30 years. The young these days have glued to TV screens. The old girl is dying on the floor. Once more to the boards, one more curtain call. Give the crowd everything they're asking for and more. Always make them laugh, try to make them cry. Always take the stage like it's the last night of your life. My friends from theater school all thought I was a fool for leaving Shakespeare for the music hall. And now my son's left home and struck out on his own. Critics think we're quaint but set to fail. They've only seen the show from the stars. Once more to the boards, one more curtain call. Give the crowd everything they're asking for and more. Always make them laugh, try to make them cry. Always take the stage like it's the last night of your life. And all the things I've seen beyond these tattered seams, and all the upturned faces with the lamplight in their eyes, each imperfect turn flickers as it burns, only lasts a moment, but for me it'll never die. We are respected, we're not remembered. We are the ghosts of our bill. Yeah, we'll never be famous. We aren't just artists for something more. We're entertainers. I smoothed my thinning hair in a gilded mirror, tried to hide the tell signs of my age. My name is Balthazar Impresario. Tonight will be my last night on the stage.
And for those of you who don't know him, because you're going to be listening to my account, this is Mark, and he's obviously incredible. One thing I asked people to do when Matt was sick was to try to maybe make him feel a little more positive. So I asked people to send me clips of videos, not like we're gonna miss you, Matt, and stuff. So he did not want that. He said to me once, I don't think he got his movies right, but he said, look, Chris, I don't want to be like the island of Dr. Moreau sitting in a chair dying and people are coming to pay tribute. Like, I didn't say anything. I'm like, you'd be turned into animal experiments? So I knew what he meant though. He wanted to try to keep things positive. So I asked people to say briefly, because I don't know how many of these things is going to, you know, something they always liked about Matt, admired, or learned from him. So he got to see most of these. Some of them he didn't get to see because I couldn't re-edit and get it to him. But he saw most of these. But we're gonna play them now. So hopefully this will work.
Mr. Matthew, what's up, dude? I need you to keep sending me movie and television show pitches like you do over Facebook Messenger. They're always good, and I will continue stealing them to use for my own financial gain in the future. A bit that you did a few years ago that I still think about all the time was when you were reffing in LA and you said, look, there's a plant in the audience, and you had put a literal freaking plant in a chair. And I said, this guy came from Portland, Maine, with a potted plant just to do this bit. And that's the Matt Russell story. Love you, buddy.
Hi, Matt. We were going to mention this last week, and we actually forgot. We're getting married today, and we wanted to just like say we're thinking of you today. And it was really nice to see you this week. And Sean was going to say something.
I was going to say, you taught me to commit to the bit. And guess that's what we're doing.
So this is.
My first Comedy Sports main stage match was with Matt. It was a 2-1-2. And it was probably only the third or fourth time that I had met Matt. He was in the very first Comedy Sports match I saw when I was 18, and about 3 years later, here I was, you know, performing in a pretty high-pressure situation with him, and I was pretty nervous, and before the match, he gave me a hug and said, I love you, have fun, don't fuck up, and I think we had fun. I don't remember the match very much. You know, fucked up somewhat. And after that, I did that, he was nice to me anyway. And I think that's something that's very constant in Matt. And I appreciate him for that. And I love you, Matt.
Matt, you ripped my first championship experience ever. Thanks for having my back. I'm going on tonight as captain. Whoop whoop.
Matt, how's it going? It's Johnny in Florida. Just wanted to say that I don't think I've ever consumed as much frozen yogurt since first joining Comedy Sports with you and Karate at Arden Mall or at Pinkberry or whatever the frozen yogurt place is. I don't remember. But yeah, dude, I pass by frozen yogurt places all the time. I go, I think I've had my lifetime frozen. So hope you feel better soon, man. Good vibes and stay constant.
What's cracking like a boosh mackin'?
Listen, I want to give you a shout out real quick because there's something that I've been on my, that I've been like sticking with me that you told me that I've carried with me through both my shit posts, my comedy styles, and just things I found funny, and it's honesty. The one thing you've always taught me that what made comedy good was the honesty of it. And so what I want to honestly tell you is that I love you. I want to say thank you. Keep going.
Hey, Matt, it's Molly. I just wanted to stop by and say how much I love you and admire you. You have taught me so much. You have taught me the value of silliness and whimsy. And if imagination was a person, I think it would be you. But hopefully not as you dressed as Winnie the Pooh, because that shit was scary last night. I love you so much. I did my first shows with you. You influenced me then, and you still do now. Every show I do, you're there, and I'm so lucky. I love you, buddy.
Hey, let's crack a leg and boogie sound. I just wanted to tell you how much I love and appreciate you, and that I'm really glad that we've been talking a lot more these past few months. I've always admired your absolute gold standard of improv and your commitment to bits. And I really appreciate all the wedding advice over the last few months.
Thank you.
I love you, man.
Take three, action. So before a show where I had been going through something and it was very apparent, Matt pulls me aside and gives me advice that he had heard from someone else that was, I may not know who you are or where you're from or what you're going through, but know that I love you and I'm there for you. And that is something that I've always remembered and tried to live my life by and will always continue to live my life by. And I'm trying to grow tomatoes here. I planted them and just let the water run. They seem to be growing, but I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing.
Hey, man, yes! And two things I want to tell you. One, I really appreciate that you sent those paint swatches to everybody. I still got mine with a little drawing of me on it. It's super cool. I look at it all the time because you're a very lovely guy and you send all sorts of love into the world.
Hello,
two,
love.
Two, you said the funniest joke about the dentist at 10:30. You said 10:30 at time. It's the funniest thing. I know it was a mistake, but it's a great joke. Love you.
I remember when I won Improviver, it was a super tough season for me because just nobody wanted to work with me strategically. I was feeling really down and bad about myself, like, socially. And when I won, Matt Russell gave me a hug and he whispered in my ear, "The true winner won." And that just really validated me and just shows what a true, genuine spirit Matt is.
One of my favorite things about Matt is his commitment. Not only can this man commit to a bit like nobody else, but he commits to his friendships as well. There's been so many times where I've received phone calls or text messages from him at random times of the night, and just to check in and see how I'm doing, or send me a sonic fact or something like that. That's one of my favorite things about Matt, is that he is just one of the most committed, loyal people I have ever met in my entire life.
Matt, I really like that you are incredibly welcoming. I take forever to fit in with a new group of people wherever I go, but I felt welcome. You made me feel welcome in comedy sports before I even joined.
Yeah, some years ago I met you, and even though I'm very unfunny, you told me I needed to do comedy sports. I did. Fast forward a few years, and now I'm married, and I blame that all on you. So,
hey Matt, it's Annabelle. I just wanted to say thank you for making every room you enter happier and for being my mom's favorite improviser. Also, check out. I still have this postcard you sent me like a billion years ago when you first moved to Portland. Anyways, I miss you. I love you. Bye.
Matthew Danger Russell, King of Fitness. I admire so much your ability to take a kernel of an idea and expand and ask the if this then what of that idea. And you take it to a stage or to a screen or to a bar or to the mailboxes. And I love to be a part of those experiences, and I love to watch you create those experiences. And I love you.
When I first came to comedy sports, I didn't really know who I was. All right, I'm starting again, but this time I shave my neck. I was still figuring all this stuff out. Like, I didn't know who I was. I didn't know what I wanted. And I had this conversation with Matt that stuck with me even to today, where he said that success is about happiness and that you define your own happiness. And I didn't understand that at the time, but then after years, it really became stop trying. Just allow yourself to be. That changed everything. There was a clear distinction between my life before I met Matt and after. And everything got better. So, I love you, Matt.
Okay, so we're gonna go to our closing. So we're gonna be singing Rainbow Connection. And then we're gonna hang out and share good memories and stuff. Support there, be there for each other.
Are there words?
I mean, I know it, but.
There are.
Get things out and ready. So if you all just give me a couple minutes, me and my friends who are helping to get everything ready before.